The silence says it all. Hey, yep, Voxesto here, and tonight we are doing an ARK build, but it's kind of an ARK repair. Spares and repairs of your base guards because they've ruined our vault. What? This is absolutely a joke, so I'm going to get stuck in and fix this old vault base, what we've done a video for only like 2 weeks ago. If you like the episode, smash your thumbs up, sub if you're new to the channel, you know the drill. So, having a look around, obviously, look at that, look, it's just not protected by vaults whatsoever anymore. We've got some open spots and stuff. Look, you can fit a whole vault in here, and there's a massive gap to the wall. It's just a ridiculous joke. So what we're going to do is we're gonna make the most of it. I mean, look what you get back as well. Oh, no, I've not got the thing on. Oh, it don't matter anyway. You don't even need to know. I'll just tell you. It's like the cost of a vault is more now. And look in here. This is like not even a thing anymore. It's rubbish. Like, you get right back there. Let me just pick this bezler up. Look at that. Smash that in. That's not protected. But yeah, they've upped the price of the vault. Well, the cost of the vault. So it's like you probably wouldn't be protecting your base with these vaults, because you're going to need a lot more of them just to make the space what would cover from just one before. So it's pretty stupid. But I suppose with this build, we've actually gained an extra bit of room up here, because there was a vault here. So what we're going to do is we're going to rearrange this bit. I'm going to take it all down. We're going to take down all the vaults around the outside, and then we're going to rework the base, get it protected again. And yeah, this will be repairing a base after the vault got ruined, I guess. Right, here it is with no vaults around it anymore. I mean, we've got all these wires, like they're not covered up anymore. It looks pretty shabby. So what we're going to do is we're going to try and find the best way to do this. Now, we know we can get about two walls on the outside. You could just do two walls and just make like an airlock all the way around, or whatever you call it, like a just blank spot. But we want to do a little bit more than that, because we want to protect our wires. So get some pillars for the sides. Look, this is on the right hand side of the base. And the pillars will just go straight down if you built your base. You know, if you built this base before off my build guide, obviously it'd be the same. But on the back, you ain't going to be able to put the pillars exactly straight in like you can here. So we're going to do some workarounds and that. Get these cables protected. Then we're going to get the walls in and stuff like that. I mean, what you could do is you could just throw like a ceiling in like this. See if we can get a bezeler on there. No? Yeah? There you go. Fence foundation on. And then it should let you just snap one of these on to the side to give that new snap point, and then we'll be able to work off that. Come on, I've just seen you. Where is it? Where'd it go? There it is. And then there you go. That'll protect it enough. And then we'll be able to do that all over. Get that all sorted. And then Bob's your uncle, job's good, and getting on it, proper boshing it. So get all that done, that's what I reckon. Right, the next problem you might come to trying to put these pillars all the way around to protect these cables is towards the entrance on these corners. You're also going to have that funny one, so just place one on that corner facing towards the base. And look, you don't get anything there. So what you want to do is, let me just make sure you definitely don't get one there. No, you definitely don't. That does not work. So, trying it again, facing this way, you can put them in. So it's more down to the direction you're facing when you're placing the pillars as to whether or not you can bloody blink actually place one there. So obviously it sticks out a little bit like that electrical box does, but don't worry about that too much, because you're going to have loads of backup ones, so they can go for it and sort of knock out whichever ones they choose, but they're never going to knock them all out, because you're going to have too many hidden about, so it's all good. So just like that. I ain't got any more pillars, let me just grab some. So like that. And I'd suggest just do both of them like that. Just cover it up, that little extra bit, and you should be all good. So rinse, repeat, do it the other side. Right, so with both of them corner bits done, what a hassle. This is the left hand side, then the back. Just put ceilings absolutely everywhere. It just helps with defense, just makes it a bit stronger. I'll put a little wall in there, and yeah, so all them pillars in, all your cables are protected. Just adds that extra little level of defense as well, because it's going to be awkward to walk through, and it's just messing about really, isn't it? So next up, we're going to be just sorting some walls out on the side to wrap around it, because now we've got to go back to old school stuff, and we're probably going to take a little bit higher, sort of just so it overhangs, like goes up past the top, so we can still use that roof access sort of dyno storage. Right, so up the top we've got these like little turret towers what we had, so we're going to get rid of them in a minute, but we're going to throw some more ceilings down just to cover up where all these pillars are, and I'll just speed this up quickly. Right, there we go, that's nice. So now we can obviously get some walls in, stuff like that. That's on a corner bit there. You know, some of these bits will stick out a little bit, but that's not a problem. It's nothing to worry about. So I'm just going to throw some walls down up here. Probably do them like too high or whatever, so just wrap around the edge again. Now we have something what looks a little bit more of like a protected base. We've got walls all the way around, look. We've got that little overhang bit at the top. And then if we just go around, obviously you can see that can be like 2 or 3 thick, and then you've got a blank layer, and then obviously more. The back bit, we've got an extra layer on to make that a tougher part to break into, because, you know, it's the back of your base. People tend to go from the back because they think they're being clever, but not this time. No, no, no. We've got an extra layer there just to keep it nice and safe, because we've got all them ceilings in there as well, so it's easy to get the extra layer, extra snap point and that sort of malarkey. So let's go inside. Yeah, looks nice. Don't look any different inside. But yeah, so we're going to need to jump up the top. I'll quickly go up there and show you, and we'll finish off that top bit now as best we can. Can I reach that? Oh, you're joking. I only had one on me as well. There we go, look. We only needed one more. Oh, nearly. Yep, okay, that'll do it. Climb the ladder. Right, so, oh look, I didn't even put a ceiling there. Pop a ceiling there. Actually, pop two there, look. Or just pop one in the right place the first time. Look, I've done it wrong there as well. What? How did I not fall off that? Strangeness. Right, so, we'll take a couple of these turrets out, because we'll want to be placing them right to the edge. I've got a couple here already sorted to place. I'll probably need 4. Then we're just going to go with one there, so we can overlook that side a little bit. Not a vault. Got one on the tippy corner bit, and then one in the little gap. Now we'll just do the same the other side. Oh yeah, turn them on. Don't forget to turn them on, guys. They don't shoot at people if you don't turn them on. Stuff like that. Right, we'll do that in a minute. So here we go, I've got 2 walls high all the way around. And then we're literally just going to be putting some ceilings in, I reckon. So here we go. We've got 2 lots of ceilings both sides. How is this plan even up here? It's really weird. So we've got 2 ceilings wide overhanging. We're just going to throw a couple of new vaults in. Just because we'll be landing up. Land our quets up here, our other flies. We'll put a lot of turrets up here as well. It's just like a makeshift storage for your dinos. I mean, if you wanted to, you could just like give it a complete ceiling, put a little dino gate at the front where that overhang is, and you'll be able to get your flies up here, no worries. Or even use one of the hatch frames. It's totally up to you how you do it. But for this build, I'm just for the example, I'm just leaving it open plan at the top, because it's not really too much of a problem. Just drop these 2 vaults in this side as well. What's going on with that? Ah, too close to the wall. Look at that, perfect. So we've got 4 vaults up here. And then we'll just put some turrets along the top and some turrets underneath as well. Flush up the turrets at the front, do whatever. and it's starting to come along now. Right, so where we had a vault covering the Jenny before, we're actually just going to throw two layers of walls. Just not like that. Don't be wasteful. Just going to cover it up, block it off the walls, get them in nice and easy. Eight walls, a lot cheaper than a vault, because it's too much of an odd shape now for a vault. And it's simple as, when you want to put more gasoline in it, you know, you can go through there, or you could even just keep this little cubby hole here and just demolish these two walls every time you want to change the gasoline in it. You know, it's one way of doing it, because you won't have to go in and out of there a lot, so it's quite easy to just replace that wall, do it like that, keep it snug and hidden, and that should be alright. I mean, if you wanted to, you could pop a vault in front of it as well, just like that. Look, just pop a little one in there. I mean, you don't have to, you could pop two in there if you really wanted to, it's up to you. Now on to the actual base itself. I mean, these doors here, they're absolutely useless now, so go ahead, replace them with walls if you want to. You could leave them there as like suicide doors or little ways to jump into your sort of airlocks along the outside, but to start off with, I'm just going to place a wall there so I've got some sort of guidance on this fabricator, because obviously in K mode, when you've got a ceiling above you, the fabricator just goes on the roof every time. So we've just placed that there. Obviously you can see I'm putting that on two ceilings, and you know, you could place it better than that, you know, it don't matter though, that's good enough for me. And then we want to try and make it so it's not accessible from right here, because obviously that little hatch frame's the way up, the easiest way up. So putting a vault probably in a corner against the back wall preferably, because we know that's our strongest wall. That's got like too many layers there. Just too many layers, people. Put as many as you can in. Be ridiculous. But from there, we'd probably want to walk all the way around the outside till we get to this vault, so we'll make it as hard as we can to get to the vault itself, because that's where you want to put your biscuits. I don't want anyone nicking your biscuits off you. What will you dunk on them faithful nights? So we'll probably have two smithies. We'll probably place one. I mean, we don't want it to have a double room. No, we can't get it very close to the vault, so we'll place one sort of earlier, easier to access in the base, probably somewhere around here, so there can be a door to a room with a smithy quite early on. Let's see if I can just creep it towards. Now I do want to get that wall in though, so about there will probably do us. Then we know we can put two walls there, and we'll also be able to get walls here as well. So pop them in. Don't pop any more in yet. Obviously, do it. At, you know, place them as you've already placed your stuff, and then to get it out of the way, because every base does need one in case you need to mind wipe at any point, especially if you're on your own. You want to get a cooking pot in. Nah, it's going to make that a little bit tricky. So what we'll do is we'll make sure that's two walls high back there. And yeah, it should be alright. I mean, that's there. We can put a wall in, well, a door in between them. We know we've got the extra room to double wall. I haven't actually got any doors on me, so we'll just crack on with it. We'll just wing it as we go and try and fit everything up here, really. I mean, there's plenty of room, but I want to sort of make it a bit more of a maze. So we're going to need to wall this way. Possibly put these walls in now. I mean, one of them might be a door, so you have to get right into the middle before you access it. Might end up having a door there actually, but let's just say, because it's the middle bit and it's hardest to get to, we'll put a chem bench in there as well. Plop the walls on, and we'll actually have an alright bit of space to put a bed in. We might be able to squeeze a bed in. See, that's where I'd have a door. We'll get to that in a minute though. I wonder if we could squeeze a bed in there. I'm tempted to try, you know. I don't think I've got beds on me, so let's quickly throw it in. I think it's 129. She'll do. No, it's too small, isn't it? Too tight. Too tight for a bed. We can put one here though, because we want a spawn point like in a harder to reach place as well. I mean, you can dot some spawn points all around your base, because obviously if you're getting raided you won't be able to come in from different locate from different angles. Come at them at all angles. They won't know what's going on. So down here, because we've got some room, what we may as well use up, we'll just place some mortars. Then we'll have a little step back and a look. Yeah, looks alright. Looks alright to me. Now we need to think about getting a fridge in at this point, because fridges are a bit funny sometimes. I mean, probably over here would be alright. Let's see if we can't put one somewhere along here. We're going to put it sideways so I don't stick through, and we've definitely got room to walk past it. Now that vault at the end, let's just grab some more metal door frames. That vault at the end, we don't necessarily have to go in there. As long as we can open and close the door, we'll be able to access the vault. So let's try and throw the fridge sort of a little bit, go for the middle, but a little bit more to the back, like that. Look, see, we can access that, and then fingers crossed, straight through. Look, lovely. Well, that looks good to me. I'll throw a door in there. Throw a door in there. Now we're literally going to be running around throwing doors absolutely everywhere we can. That's a nice spot. I like that one. I'll have one there. Now this is, you know, this is a bit what's going to be a little bit tricky. But, you know, you just make do with what you can, really. I don't mind having a little jump puzzle. Whee! Oh, that was like a speed ramp, wasn't it? I want another go at that. Oh wow, I really suck at jumping over this. Right, so I'll probably show you an easier way to get around this in a minute. Whoa. That's really weird how you just speed up when you go over it. How bizarre. And then, what have we got? We've got the old grillsies. They're easy places. If you're in like a sort of foundation space, you can always get you back to the wall and just pop them in. About there, that'll probably do. Yeah, you can walk through there, that's alright. I mean, we don't need a wall or a door in there. Having that open corridor is probably quite a nice thing. And then, we're definitely not going to fit one of these guys in. We could have done at the start, but I don't see the use in them. You know, if you really want one, you can put one of them in first. I'm sure you can work around it. So campfire, I bet that gets demolished in about 1 minute, because it'll be in the way for some reason. And then a second smithy. I mean, we could put a second smithy in here and have the part where it is like two walls high, so you have to sort of jump over it. Look, here we go, I'm already going to demolish this. Wasting my time. So just put your smithy this way around. Doesn't really, you know, there's no harm in jumping over it. Just makes it a bit more fun when you're going around your base. Have a little jumping puzzle. Not much of a puzzle, it's just jump over. But yeah, so I think we've nearly got everything we need. To be honest, we've got a fridge and yet still get to that. Stuff like this, a bit of that. Have a look. Let's get some ceilings. That was hatch frames. Why did I do that? Get some ceilings. Yep, there we go. He's boshed it now, hasn't he? So we'll just plop them in. And then we'll jump, probably just jump up there and do it from here. So we're going to go ascent a bit, definitely. Get where the fridge is, definitely. That can definitely be one. This one we're going to have too high. Definitely put one there. Definitely put one here. Same again, because that's all one corridor, so we may as well match it up all the way. And then this smithy bit has to be two as well, because we're going to have to be able to jump over it. So, do your usuals. Let's just get some walls. This menu's weird, isn't it? I think I'm used to it now, though. Need some more doors, don't we? What happened there? Oh, I was like, oh, yeah, that's a stupid number. Get some door frames. And then we're going to want... We'll just put one there. Wall the rest. And then, you know, just wall off that middle bit. You can wall off whatever you want, really, to be honest. We're just going to put a door frame here in case we ever want to use that top space as like an extra spawn. And then that one there. And we need to do the vault as well. I mean, you could do a door there so you can access your vault from above if you do need to just get out in a hurry. You know, you could spawn into this bit, quickly grab stuff out of your vault, and then just demolish a bit in the ceiling and just up and out, just go. Right, so needs a little bit of a tidy, so I'll go ahead and tidy it up a bit, and I think it's about time to have a look at the finished product, really. Right, so we've successfully converted our vault base into a not so vault base, because the vaults are just ridiculously small and overcost. But obviously you can see I've put some turrets around it on the catwalks. Just your usual typical sort of arky thing. Don't forget to put some plant X's as well. You definitely need both. I've just popped turrets in. And we'll just go up top and get rid of that for a second. Obviously you can see I've got some turrets from above, some turrets down below. Be a perfect spot to put some plant X in the middle up there. Just replace this little Bobby Dazzler. Look at that beauty. And then just go ahead and jump down. Obviously that's the only thing we're going to be doing from like dropping our flyers off is jumping down. I mean, you can find your own way up there every time. That's just what I want to do. So Jenny's in there. Obviously all these doors and that, you probably want to just wall them off, get rid of them. Then we've got the vault in the middle. Not a lot in that. I mean, what you could do, let's just grab some walls. Just want to try and weigh myself down a bit, because I'm moving like ridiculously fast. Is that? No, I think I need some more. No, a little bit less. Isn't that a funny sound it makes? Right, so I'm just giving up. Right, so what we've got up here, we've got cooking pot. You've literally just seen this, so it's a bit pointless me going around, but now you can see it with all the doors and that, make sure they all work. So in there we've got smithy, just jump and then crouch. Smithy number one, and then just crouch, run over that. Simple as. Open this door up. There we go. We've got the old grill, and then Bosh. We've got a sneaky turret there. We can't really see until it's too late. So, adding a few of these dotted around the base is definitely a good thing. You know, it's definitely going to make it harder work and a bit more frustrating when anyone raids you, having the internal turrets. I mean, you can keep these doors in if you want that access to your bubble around the base, but I'd just remove them. Maybe keep one. See, enough turret there. Come through here. Second smithy. And another turret having a pokey feel at you. And then this one just goes out into some suicide door to the perimeter wall. And then another turret in here. It's time you got this way to go. You got your bed, you got a chem bench, mortars. You can get to all of them, it's all nice. And then I've changed where the door to the fabricator is, because it was in there before, look, right there. But I didn't like it there. I thought it much neater to actually put it in this room, so it's a bit harder to reach. So there is the fabby, a location, and then vault at the end. You know, enough said really. A couple of just empty rooms with turrets in along the way. And I mean, them suicide doors, if you did keep them in, people might get confused and actually try and go through them thinking they're getting to another point in the base, which would be pretty funny because they'd end up going back out of the base. But yeah, so hope you can get your own vault bases repaired and sorted, guys. Hope you liked the episode. Don't forget to smash the thumbs up button if you did. Subscribe if you're new to the channel, guys. We'll see you next time. Take it easy.